Today, I'm going to discuss looping, counting, and indexing. Let's see what is looping. The programming technique is used to instruct the microprocessor to repeat a task is called looping. This task is accomplished by using jump instructions. The loop instructions, that is the looping, can be classified into two types. The first one is continuous loop. The second one is conditional loop. See one by one. The first one, continuous loop. So continuous loop is nothing but repeat a task continuously. Okay, that is called continuous loop. Second type, conditional loop. A conditional loop is set up by a conditional jump instructions. These instructions check flags, that is zero flag, carry flag, parity, and sign flag, and repeat the task if the conditions are satisfied. The loop include counting and indexing. Okay, see the next topic, conditional loop and counter. A counter is a typical application of the conditional loop. A microprocessor needs a counter flag to accomplish the looping task. Counter is set up by the loading an appropriate count in a register. So counting is performed by either increment or decrement the counter. Loop is set up by a conditional jump instruction. End of counting is indicated by a flag. Then, so these are the flowcharts of continuous loop and conditional loop with the counter. See the first flowchart, start operation, then perform task, then go back and repeat it. Okay, so the same task will be repeated more times if the processor is reset, means that time only the task will be completed. Okay, so that is called continuous loop. So first start the operation, then do the task, then again the same process will be repeated. Okay, so that is called continuous loop. The second one is conditional loop with the counter. Here first start the operation, then set the counter value, okay, then do the task, then after completed task, then decrement the counter value by 1, then check the counter value reaches 0 or not. If reaches 0 means stop the task, otherwise the task will be continuous till the counter value reaches 0. So this type is called as conditional loop with counter. So these are the difference between continuous loop and conditional loop with the counter. Okay, the next one is conditional loop, counter, and indexing. Another type of loop which includes counter and indexing. So indexing is nothing but pointing or referencing object with the sequential numbers, that is called indexing. Okay, so indexing means pointing or referencing object with the sequential numbers. Example, in a library, books are arranged according to the numbers and they are referred to or stored by numbers. So this is called indexing. Similarly, data bytes are stored in memory locations and those data bytes are referred to by their memory locations. So these are the examples of indexing. Okay, the next topic is lookup table. A lookup table is an array of data to map input values to output values. That is called lookup table. So lookup table allows to replace runtime computation or logic circuitry with a simpler array indexing operation. Okay, see the example to find square from lookup table. So this is lookup table. So the lookup table starting address is 2600 to 2609. So each address contains one data. Okay, so this is program for finding square value. Okay, suppose 0 square value is 0. 1 square is 1, 2 square is nothing but 4, 3 square is nothing but 9, 4 square 16, 5 square 25, 6 square 36, 7 square 49, then 8 square 64, 9 square 81. Okay, so these informations are already stored. Okay, so that table is called as lookup table. So the lookup table starting address is 2600, here ending address is 2609. Okay, see the program. The first instruction LDA2500. So 2500 indicates data address. So this data address content is loaded into the accumulator. So that is the function of LDA2500. See, 2500 data is nothing but 07. Okay, so this 07 is loaded into the accumulator. That is the function of LDA2500. So the input data is loaded into accumulator. Okay, what is next step? The accumulator content is loaded into L register. What is accumulator content? Accumulator is nothing but 07. So this 07 is moved to L register. Now L register content is 07. Okay, then next instruction MVIH,26. So 26 is immediately moved to H register. Okay, so H contains 26, L contains 07. So HL is nothing but 2607. What is 2607? It is nothing but 49. So the input is 07. The square of 07 is nothing but 49. So from the lookup table, the 49 is moved to the accumulator using move A, M. Okay. So move A, M is nothing but, M is nothing but HL register. HL register contains 2607. 2607 is nothing but 49. So this content is moved to accumulator. Okay. The next instruction STA2501. STA means store accumulator content to the specified memory location. Here memory location is nothing but 2501. So in that location the accumulator content will be stored. So this is the program for to find square from lookup table. Okay, the last instruction, that is a halt. Halt is nothing but stop. Stop the process. Okay, clear? See, the next topic is assembly language format. So assembly language is nothing but a program. That program are written using character strings called mnemonics, so that they are more easily understood by people. So assembly language instructions have more or less 1-to-1 correspondence with machine language instructions. Okay, so that is called assembly language program. Already you know the assembly language details. Assembly language is only understood by human beings, not by the computers. In assembly language, data can be represented with the help of mnemonics such as move instruction, add instruction, subtract instruction, end instruction, etc. Then assembly language is easy to understand by the human being as compared to the machine language. So modification and error fixing can be done in assembly language. Easy to memorize the assembly language program because some alphabets and mnemonics are used. Here execution speed is low compared with the machine language. That is the only disadvantage of assembly language. In case of assembler, the assembler is used to translate to convert mnemonics into machine language, machine understandable form. Then assembly language is the machine dependent and it is not portable. So these are the details about assembly language. Here the assembly language format contains 4 fields. The first one is label field, the second one opcode field, the third one is operand field, and fourth one is command field. Okay, so this is the format. The first column label, second column opcode, third column operand, and fourth column command field. Let's see one by one. The first field is called label field. Labels are the most frequently used in branching instruction. Okay, a label is a symbol or group of symbols used to represent the address of the instruction that is not specifically known. and subsequently this label can be used as an address or as data in other instructions, that is operand field. Then the assembler will assign a binary value, then it will replace the labels in the operand field with the assigned binary value when creating the object program. So labels are usually restricted in length to 5 or 6 characters. The first character must be a letter. Then a particular label can be used only once in the label field. The label field may be empty. So this is about label field. Okay, the second one is opcode field. So already you know the details of opcode field. The operation code field usually contains the mnemonics instruction code. It is the only field that can never be empty. The assembler will translate these opcodes into corresponding binary codes. Sometimes the operation code field may also contain directives to the assembler. So they have no binary equivalent but have corresponding assembler subroutines that produce the prescribed action. So this is about opcode field details. The next one is operand field. The field contains the name of the registers, data or address on which the operation is to be performed. It may also contain a label representing binary number. Then the last column, that is command field. The command field is used to explain the function of the instruction. It tells what the programmer is doing and helps to read, understand and document the program. It command have no effect on the object code. So these are the details of the assembly language format. Let's see the examples. The first example, write a program to place 05 in register B. So this is the program for to place 05 in register B. So here using MVIB, this instruction is used for to place the 05 in B register. Okay, so 05 is nothing but 8-bit data. So this data is immediately moved to the B register, then stop the program. So this is the program to place 05 in register B. Then second example, write a program to get 05 in register A, then move it to register B. So 8-bit data first move to the A register, thereafter from A to B. So that is the procedure. Okay, see the program. So MVI A,05. So 05, this data is immediately moved to accumulator register. Then thereafter from the accumulator, the content will be moved to the B register. So accumulator is nothing but, the content is nothing but 05. So this 05 is moved to B register. So after execution of first and second instruction, A register value 05, B register value 05. Then stop the program. So this is second example. Third example, write a program to load the content of the memory location 8500 directly to the accumulator, then transfer it to register B. The content of memory location 8500 is 05. Okay, so this is the program. Here see the question, to load the content of memory location 8500 directly to the accumulator. So directly to the accumulator means which instruction? LDA, this instruction. Okay, LDA expansion is load accumulator directly. So using LDA instruction, the 05 is moved to the accumulator, then transfer to the B register. Okay, so first 8500, so this is address. This address contains 05. So the content of 8500 is loaded to the accumulator. Okay, that is the function of first instruction. Then second instruction is the content of accumulator is moved to B register. Okay, so A is nothing but 05, B is nothing but 05. From the accumulator, the content is moved to B register, then stop the program. So this is third example. Fourth one, write a program to move the content of memory location 8500 to register C. The content of memory location 8500 is 0H. Here data is 08. 8-bit data, that is 08. Address is 8500. Okay. So this data is moved to C register. So this is the program. So LXI H, 8500. So 8500 is nothing but 16-bit data. So this 16-bit data is immediately loaded into HL register. Okay, so H is nothing but 85. L register is nothing but 00. Okay, then what is M? M is nothing but HL. A memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair. HL register pair is nothing but 8500. That content is moved to the C register. What is the content? 8500 is nothing but 08. So C register value is 08. Then stop the program. So this is the explanation of fourth program. Then fifth one is, write a program to place the content of the memory location 8500 in register B and that of 8501 in register C. The content of 8500 and 8501 are 11 and 12 or 11 and 12 in hexadecimal numbers. Okay, see here two memory locations, two datas. The first memory location 8500, the second memory location 8501. So the first data is 11, the second data is 12. The first data stored in 8500, the second data is stored in 8501. So this is the program for this. So already you know LXI H, 8500. So 8500 indicates 16-bit data. So this data is immediately loaded into HL register pair. Okay, then second instruction. So memory is nothing but HL register. So HL register contains 8500. That content is moved to the B register. So what is the content? 8500. 8500 is nothing but H register is 85, L register is 00. So B register is nothing but 11, because 8500 stores 11, 8501 stores 12. So 8500 content is 11. So that content is moved to the B register. Okay, then increment H. So increment H means HL register pair is incremented by 1. Already HL register pair 8500. After execution of INX H, the HL pair value is 8501. So 8501 content is 12. So the content of 8501 is moved to C register. Okay, that is 12. So this is the explanation of fifth program. Then sixth example, write a program to place 05 in the accumulator, increment it by 1 and store the result in the memory location 8500. See the program. So first data is immediately moved to the accumulator, then increment A. So increment A means after execution of INR A, the accumulator is 06. Okay, before execution, accumulator value is 05. After execution of INR A, the accumulator content is 06. Okay, then STA 8500. STA means store accumulator content to the specified memory address. Okay, here accumulator content is nothing but 06. So this 06 is stored in 8500. That is 8500 is equal to 06. So this is the program, sixth program details. Then next one is seventh one. Here write a program to add 2 8-bit data and store the result in the consecutive memory locations. So this is the algorithm for adding 2 8-bit datas. So this is the program for adding 2 8-bit numbers. Here the first instruction is MVI C, 00. So this is nothing but clear the C register. Okay, C register actually used for to store the carry value. So for that purpose, initially C register is cleared. Okay, then second instruction LXI H, 8500. So 8500 is nothing but data address. this data address is immediately loaded into HL register pair. Okay, then move A comma M. M is nothing but HL register pair. So that content is moved to the accumulator. So first data is moved to the accumulator. That is the function of move A comma M. Okay, then INX H. So INX H means increment the memory address. Okay, increment the HL register pair. So that is the function of INX H. So before increment operation, HL register is nothing but 8500. After execution of INX H, the HL register contains 8501. So that content is added with accumulator content. That is 8501 content is added with accumulator content. Then check the carry flag. JNC means jump no carry. Okay, check the carry flag. If no carry means move to the INX H instruction. Okay, so no carry means move to the directly move to the INX H instruction, because this is label. L1 indicates a label. Label is specified in this instruction. Okay, this is L1. So this is label. Okay, so label is specified here only. So skip this instruction, that is INRC, skip this, directly move to the INX H instruction. So INX H means, once again, increment the HL register pair, that is 8502. Okay, then the accumulator content is stored in that location. So the accumulator contains the result adding to 8-bit number value. So that result will be stored in 8502. That is memory. Okay, once again increment the HL register, that is 8503. Then in that location the carry value will be stored. Then finally stop the program. Okay, suppose if carry value present means increment the C register value. Already C register value 00. If any carry present means increment the carry value, that is C register value. So C value is equal to 1 means carry value present. That is the meaning. So after incrementing C register, do the next instruction, next operation, INX H. Okay, then after that the result will be stored in specified memory location. Once again increment the HL register, then carry flag is stored in that location, then stop the program. So this is the program for adding two 8-bit datas. Similarly, subtraction program. Type a program to subtract two 8-bit data and store the result in the consecutive memory location. So this is the algorithm. So this is the program. So already you know C register is used for to store carry value. So this is subtraction program. So for subtraction, borrow value is stored in C register. For borrow, there is no separate flag. C register, the same carry flag is used to store carry value as well as borrow value. Okay, so C register is used for to store the borrow value. So for that purpose, initially the C register is cleared. Okay, then after that, 8500 indicates a data address. So this data address is immediately loaded into HL register. Okay, so HL register content is moved to A. That means the first data is moved to the accumulator. Then increment HL. So increment HL means 8501. Okay, then subtract memory. So subtract memory means memory is nothing but HL register. So the HL register content is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. Then the answer is placed in the accumulator. Okay, so here second data available, here first data available. So second data is subtracted from the content of accumulator. Then after that the answer is stored in accumulator register. Then check the carry flag value, whether borrow present or not. If not means directly move INX H instruction. Okay, skip these three instructions. Directly moves to the INX H instruction, because label is specified here only. Okay, So this label is specified here only. So INXH. So increment the HL register, then accumulator value is stored in that memory location. Then once again increment HL register, then C register value is stored in the specified memory location, then stop the program. In case there is no borrow value or no carry value. Suppose if borrow present means what happen to the next instruction, that is INRC, increment the C register value. Okay, so no carry means here, suppose carry present means execute the INR C instruction. So C instruction is incremented by 1. Then after that, complement the accumulator content. CMA is nothing but complement the accumulator content. Okay, complement is nothing but zeros are converted into ones, ones are converted into zeros. That is complement function. Okay, then after complementing ADI 01. So ADI 01 is nothing but 01 is added with the content of accumulator. Finally, the answer is placed in the accumulator. So after complementing, that accumulator content is added with the 01. Then that answer is stored in accumulator. So that answer is stored in the specified memory location. After incrementing HL register, that answer will be stored in memory location. Once again, increment the HL register, then carry flag is moved to the specified memory location, then stop the program. The next one is multiplication. Write a program to multiply 2 8-bit data and store the result in the consecutive memory location. So this is the algorithm for multiplication of 2 8-bit numbers. See, in 8085, there is no direct instruction available for multiplication and division. In case of multiplication, successive addition method is used. In case of division, successive subtraction method is used. This is multiplication program. The first instruction is LXIH, 8500. 8500 is the data address. So data address is immediately loaded into HL register. The memory content is moved to D register. Okay, 8500 content is moved to D register. Then increment H register. Then MVI A,00. So first clear the accumulator content. Then after that clear the C register value also. Okay, so actually C register is used for to store the carry. So A and C, both registers are cleared. Okay, so C register is used for to store the carry value. Then, so HL register content is added with the content of accumulator. The answer is placed in accumulator register. Okay, then check the carry flag. No carry means skip the INRC instruction, directly move to the DCRD because label is specified here only. So DCRB. So B register is decremented by 1. So after decrementing, check the B register content, whether the B register reaches 0 or not. If not means, do the same operation. Okay. So here label is L1. So L1 means here. Do the same process. Once again, add the HL register content with accumulator. Then answer is placed in accumulator register. Then check the carry flag. No carry means decrement. Suppose carry present means increment C register, then decrement B register. Again check it. Jump no zero. No zero means again do the same process. Suppose the B register reaches zero means it moves to the next instruction. Okay, that is INXH. HL register is incremented by 1. Okay, in that location, the answer will be stored. Okay, so after incrementing HL register, the accumulator content will be stored in that location. Once again, increment the HL register pair, then the carry value is stored in that location, then stop the program. So this method is called as successive addition method for multiplication program. So this is the last example. Write a program to divide 2 8-bit data and store the result in the consecutive memory location. So this is the algorithm for division program. So this is division program. The first one is MVI B, 00. So B register is clear. B register actually used for to store the quotient value. In case of division, at last we get two answers. Okay, finally we get two answers. One is a quotient, another one remainder. So B register is used for to store the quotient value. So initially B register is cleared. Then 8500 is nothing but data address. This data address is immediately loaded into HL register. So that content is moved to the accumulator. Okay, so the first data is moved to the accumulator. Then increment HL register pair. Then SUB. SUB means subtract. Subtract memory content with accumulator. Okay, memory is nothing but HL register. HL register content is subtracted from the content of accumulator and the result is placed in accumulator. So after execution of SUB M, check the carry flag whether carry present or not. So here after subtracting increment B register, okay, increment B register. So this is for B register actually used for to store the quotient value. First operation over. So for that purpose here B register is incremented by 1. Then check the carry flag. If no carry means it moves to, that is loop. Here label is loop. The loop indicates here. So once again do the same operation. Again subtract operation. So after subtracting again increment B register value. Then check the carry flag. The carry present or not. Suppose carry present means do the next operation. That is add M. Okay. Memory content is added with the content of accumulator. Then decrement B register. Then increment H register. Then accumulator content is stored in specified memory location. Then increment H register. Then B register content is stored in specified memory location. Then stop the program. Okay. So here quotient value is stored in that memory location. Here remainder value is stored in that memory location. So first store the remainder value, thereafter store the quotient value. So this is the program for division. So far we have discussed assembly language types, that is machine language, assembly language, high level language, then instruction format, what is opcode, what is operand, then classification of instructions based on length, based on functions, then addressing modes of 8085 microprocessor, then summary set of 8085 instructions, then stack, subroutines, then assembly language format with examples. I am sure these topics are clear for you. Thank you.